Hello, children, boys and girls, soon to be men and women. Heard that you're going back to school, but not really. You're going to stay home, and you're going to have class on the computer. Well, interesting. For many of you that don't have computers, you go to school and obtain a computer. And you'll all have a time where you'll have to sit in front of the computer. Many of you have chosen, mostly, to play games on your phones and your computers and your game sets. And there's a lot of things in the world. You've also chose to like fast food, stuff like that. Instead of going outside and playing sports, some of you do, but the majority of time is spent on the phones, on the computers, tablets, watching movies and TVs, eating fast food instead of garden fresh food and stuff like that, hanging out with animals and things, nature. And something going on here. This is the eye of the storm, perhaps. Take it with a grain of salt. That flag behind me comes from a man's family who died at war. He was shot 3 times. The accompanying flag to that was draped over his casket, has 3 bullets in it. A friend has that. Mrs. Mom's husband. That one's in his office. You see stuff around me like art supplies. Music stuff, paintings, fruit. Little gauge of a needle right there. White dove for peace. That man, when he died, he was fighting for something called freedom, liberty, and justice for all. And now, you're about to embark on a new kind of life. I'm 46 years old. Right in the middle of old and young, kind of on the edge of young, kind of on the edge of the middle. I still remember things. Wasn't allowed to be in the military. Can't have kids of my own. I've been given a gift of insight and a vision and motivation. And I've actually had lots of trials and tribulations. Put me through a lot of circumstances where I learned things. Just by feeling, walking the line, keeping my opportunities open, you know, indulging on little life's roses and coffee. Taste the coffee, smell the roses. Breathe the fresh air. Take country walks. There used to be this thing where they were having a conspiracy about TVs having microphones in them. And all along, nobody thought, hey, it's like 17 TVs or something like that. What about radios? You know, if you ever look at a speaker and look at a microphone, it's kind of the same thing anyway. You know? But when you hear an alarm, you're going to have to go sit in front of the computer. You're going to be doing exercise in front of the computer. You're going to be doing things that you're told to do in front of the computer. You've learned to make money on it. It's amazing. It's a gift, actually. I know a 16-year-old boy. He can make $500 a week sitting on a computer. In his own room, never even comes out. Stays awake all hours, does what he wants. It's interesting. I don't judge it. But as for right now, there's something our forefathers have warned us about. And it's something that this flag behind me represents that man died for. And it's very possible that the near future, you could be embarking on something that you're going to accept that's going to erase all them efforts, all those people who died, all those people who stood strong, stood tall for your tomorrow, for your future. So this kind of thing wouldn't happen way in the past. Bob Marley said the youth is going to be strong. Our rainbow's been taken away and made into a symbol. Our freedoms have been undermined and our civil rights have went out for the sake of somebody holding a badge and a gun. backed by lawyers and threats. Is this a conspiracy? I don't know. Is the world flat? Depends how you look at it, I guess. The sun is always going to shine. But in the eye of the storm, remember, you can be that wind. You can be that sunlight. Reminds me of something in Gaelic customs and traditions, Viking kind of stuff. They got a thing called runes. They cast the runes, kind of tell the future, get a vibe, get some insight. There's one called Hagalaz. Means hail's going to come down, destroy everything. But then when that hail melts, it provides a new way for things to glow. You know? Everything could be a symbol. Everything could be an innuendo. Everything could be a tragedy or a euphoric bliss. It's up to you in the end, really. Eye of the storm, sometimes called the needle. There's an eye in the needle, you know. And as a syringe gets pressed and the vaccine gets administered, it just might be a little something extra for you. Force you to wake up, sit in front of that computer, do as you're told, without a voice. Choice on what life really could be. You'll be given four or five choices, and then you'll be allowed to choose one, and you'll say, like many of our parents did, I was free to make a choice out of them five choices, not realizing that there's 100 choices, and you've been kept from it. You know, supposedly they're taking post office boxes out of the democratic states. This way there's no, you know, nobody's screwing with the votes. Cut communication with people, you know, state by state, child by child, class by class, street by street, circumstance by circumstance. It's really up to you in the end. Bar Marley said the youth's going to be strong. You know about technology. You have an insight. Don't hate on your parents. Learn from them. Don't hide from the world around you. Adjust with it. But know that same thing that this man fought for, who died, it's going to be in your hands soon. Some of us may not make a difference at all. Might not be worth anything. Tell you about them George Guidestones now. You don't see nobody vandalizing those things. Taking around our historic symbols. Something that represents freedom. You know, maybe you don't know this, but if you had history and civics, you'd realize that America is the only country ever signified, the only area ever signified as the land of the free and the home of the brave. Freedom, liberty, and justice for all. But now it's come down to numbers and paperwork and circumstances and wants and needs. Presses of buttons to flip. And spending your sustenance on novelties just so you can feel regular. I know people to get the stimulus check. They go get a tattoo because they want to feel normal. And then they stop the stimulus check. Now they're broke. Go figure. Many of you children wouldn't mind sitting in a cubicle. Maybe a building. Could you imagine with a building and a domicile? With 1,000 cubicles in there and 1,000 comfy chairs with a little climate control and an AC and some neon lights. You know? And some kind of button you press to administer some kind of euphoric substance to yourself. You know? And everybody gets along. That's really not life. That's an accessory. You become an accessory. Perhaps, maybe, maybe not. What does it all mean? It's a great story, isn't it? How many books are written? Most popular one is probably George Orwell, 1984, Animal Farm, stuff like that. You know, you got movies all over the place, Avatar, Fifth Element. It's those things are metaphors, symbols. This has been going on for a long time. Long time. Gotta really think about it. Don't hate the old people. Don't hate the middle-aged people. We know stuff. And in the end of the day, we're gonna rely on you. Because you have the energy. You have the ability. You do have the insight. And people like me trust you. As much as we can. But show us that you're strong. Show us that you're clever. Show us that you have integrity and morals. Show us that you're educated and that you're not stupid. And show us compassion. Show us kindness. Show us love and appreciation. Because this world exists out of those same things. Or else you wouldn't be here. You wouldn't have anything already. You know, a lot of you kids, you play online games and you talk to people from other countries, in other countries. Instead of talking about things like sex, drugs, technology, music and stuff. Ask them what it's like to have freedom, to be able to look at things you want, to be able to talk about things you want to talk about, to be able to obtain the things you want and go places you want. I can guarantee a lot of those friends that you have online, they live in places that aren't very nice. But because people are satisfied sitting inside their little cubicles and looking at a screen, is it going to affect your eye? And eating fast food? It's just another vehicle. Just priming you up, ready. Ready to take that syringe. Ready to feel that frequency. Ready to be stroked out with that vision. Are you going to be used? Are you going to be a slave? Are you going to be a drone? Are you going to be a robot? Are you going to be a gimp? Or are you just looking at a method of mass suicide that you're going to willfully accept because it's going to promise you doing the same thing that you're doing now, many of you. You got to get out into the world. You got to see things. You got to ask questions. Don't have resentment. Think about the story of Romeo and Juliet. Stuff like that with Shakespeare. It's really important. You know? You're gonna have to decide to educate yourselves a little bit. And don't be deterred by, you know, the resistance. Don't be deterred by ignorance. Don't be deterred by troublesome and stubborn minds that don't want you to have things. Keep in mind, I will agree with you on a lot of things. The people from our past couldn't even say the word pregnant. They took their wives to the doctor for something called hysteria. You know, it was crazy. Even alcohol. They were busting people. They had underground clubs serving alcohol. And if you got caught with it, you went to jail for a long period of time. And now, so many things going on. So many things. So many things are considered legal. So many things are considered still illegal. You know? The thing about America is, which is much different from foreign countries, you know, America wanted to give the kids a chance to grow up and enjoy life while the adults took care of the business part. But now, with the influx of all these perpetrators, selfish ways, ignorant ways, alienistic ways. They're taking your kids and they're making you adults before you want to be. Yeah, I guess back in the 1800s, a grown man was 26 years old with a family and a house and worked a job 10 hours a day and stuff like that. The wife stayed home cooking and cleaning. These are 20-year-olds. And the way America had it was they knew that your mind could continue to grow and you could continue to have fun and continue to do things. So don't try to grow up too fast. But now that we're in this situation, you got to gauge yourself and say, wait a second. Do Do I really want to act like a 50-year-old man when I'm 16 or 17? You're going to have to save yourself. We don't know what's around the corner. A lot of conspiracy theories out there. A lot of suspicions. But if you contrast things right, you'll see that something's going on. That it ain't right. No one knows who to trust. Try to trust your family. And respect your family. If you got family. And the same as your friends. Use your brain. Think about things. Contrast things. Be patient. Take your time with things. This way you can really decide and work together to think about things. Don't take everything as your own responsibility. Don't make quick decisions. You know, don't look at the positive things without considering what else could be negative or behind that. You know, because sometimes you make a choice for one thing and there's 10 things that go with it that you're going to be sorry and regretful for later. And this can happen. It has happened in the past. You know? You see all kind of stuff in the news. All these great characters that made cartoons and inventions. And even people that made websites and laws and stuff to free people. There's a lot of background information coming out on a lot of people. They did heinous, disgusting, terrible, horrifying things and got away with it. Because they're part of a group. It's fun to sit there on the computer and the video games and the phones and see those things in virtual reality and on a small scale and think, oh, it's just entertainment. It's a lot different when you're living in it. So be well. And remember, red, white, and blue, it means something more than just a national circumstance. It stands for something. It stands for something great where anybody and everybody could have a chance. The only people that really need to have a chance right now are the good-hearted people, the kind people, the giving people, the people that follow the light. Zombies and stuff, you don't want to be a zombie. You don't want to have a friend as a zombie. That kind of stuff ain't cool. You know what? Zombies smell. They chew on each other. Their parts rot out. They don't have personalities. You know. You don't want to turn into a zombie or a robot. So you think about the things that are coming. Possibly. And take that with a grain of salt. I wish you peace, prosperity, health, wealth, goodness, positivity, and abundance. With enough to share and go around. And continue to grow. And be strong.